गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू योर वीडियो सेशन एंड दिस इज आवर ग्रामर योर लिटरेचर क्लास. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू वेदर यू हैव रेड दिस स्टोरी वट एवर आई हैव टॉट इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो और नॉट. चिल्ड्रन आई वॉन्ट यू ऑल टू रिवाइज वट एवर आई गिव यू. इफ यू रिवाइज इट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट इन अ बेटर वे. And today we are going to see what else happened with Rajan Babu. We have covered till paragraph 28 and we are going to begin from 29th para. Now here we have seen that Feluda and Topshi have come back to the house of Rajan Babu and they have decided to stay there at night. Feluda stretched out on the bed and said, I did some investigation in the afternoon and both Prabir and Vishal were at party from 9 p.m. to 3 a.m. Now what investigation? Feluda stretched out on the bed and said. Stretched out means he relaxed himself on the bed and then he told that he had investigated something. And what was it? It was that Prabir, son of Rajan Babu, and Mr. Ghoshal, owner of that shop, curio shop. These two fellows were attending some sort of party. And what was the timing of the party? From 9 p.m. to 3 a.m. Means what they have concluded with this, that the man wearing mask came here soon after midnight, didn't he? I asked. He said, okay, that means they are not the ones, because this incident, that threatening incident happened, that mass fellow came and threatened Rajan Babu at night only, and now it says that after midnight that incident took place. But these two people were already attending the party that they came to know. And so, yes, said Feluda and left the room abruptly. Feluda was telling all these to Topshi, and when Topshi wanted to tell something or speak something or to agree with what he is saying, he abruptly left the room. Abruptly means suddenly, without notice or without noticing what Topshi was trying to say. Maybe he has got some idea in the mind or he is thinking of something very important, that is why he abruptly, he quickly, suddenly left the room. I lay on the bed and must have dozed off. I means Topshi is saying, I must have dozed. Doze means must have slept. I woke up with a jolt when I sensed the presence of someone else in the room. My blood froze. It says, I lay on the bed and must have dozed and woke up with a jolt. Now what is jolt? The meaning of this word jolt is with a shock. When we wake up, when we hear some sound and we wake up suddenly, how we feel, that position, that particular position, you can say that you have woken up with a jolt. Here also suddenly with a shock he woke up. And why he got that shock? Because he sensed, he realized that somebody is in the room. And by that realization that somebody is in the room, his blood froze. This is an expression expressing that he was scared so much. He was frightened so much that he thought that now he is unable to move from the bed. Sometimes when we are afraid, we think that we are unable to speak also. Unable to move from that place. Although we want to do it, but we cannot do that, because we are afraid so much. And I opened my eyes. Somehow he opened his eyes and saw something. And what was that something? Was coming towards me. Oh, how horrible it was. Horrible means unpleasant. It was something which was coming towards me. Topshi says that it wasn't pleasant. It was so horrible for me. And what was it? It was a mask. A masked face. These people are there to investigate the masked fellow, the person who was wearing mask and scared Rajan Babu, and this fellow is also experiencing the same thing. I opened my mouth, he wanted to scream. In fear we scream and we try to call some people who are around us. And this child, this fellow is also trying to scream and wanting somebody to come and help. When the person wearing the mask pulled it away, the one who was wearing the mask who was coming towards me, when he pulled up means when he took off his mask, what I found, my scream became a nervous gasp. Now the meaning of nervous gasp is a short, quick breathing of air through our mouth. When we are afraid and when we want to relax ourselves, what we do? We gasp very quickly. We breathe very quickly with our mouth only. And this is what, when we are surprised, we generally do that, or when we are in shock. This is called nervous gasp. Feluda, oh my God, it's you. Who was he who was wearing mask? It was Feluda. Feluda abruptly left the room for something, and this is what he left for. He had this in mind that let me try all the masks which I hear. And he came with one of the masks and scared this fellow, definitely Topshi. And they found, and both of them have understood that it, later on you will find that they have understood who is the culprit. Of course it's me, he said, of course it's me, he raised the mask. I was trying on all the masks in the living room. Why don't you wear this one for a second? He passed me his mask, I wore it. Can you sense something unusual? Why? No, it's a size too large for me, that's all. Now Topshi is scared. So in order to give him some comfort, Feluda says, oh, it's me, you don't have to worry about it. It is only me. When I went to the room and I was trying, all in the living room, all these masks were there. And when I thought of trying every mask, I found this mask. Do you want to try? He asked Topshi, would you like to try this? And when he wore, Feluda asked, do you think there is something which is unusual, which is not usual thing? Something different, can you sense? And you know what answer he gave? He says that yes, the size is too large for me. The size is big. This is not of my size. My face is small. This is a large one. Think carefully. Then Feluda said, no, it's not that. It's not about the size. You think carefully. Is there anything that might strike you as odd? Well, there's a faint smell, I think. Of course, Chirut, exactly. My heart started to beat faster again. Titi Tinkori, Babu, I stammered. Feluda sighed, yes, I'm afraid so, but what I do not understand is his motive. He seemed to respect Rajan Babu a lot. Why then did he do something like this? Perhaps we shall never know. Now finally they have understood, they have smelled in that mask, they could smell that since Tinkori Babu has a weakness of smoking Chirut. I have told you so many times. And that smell of Chirut was there in the mask. By that they have understood that this mask would have worn by Tinkori Babu. And he is the only fellow who scared Rajan Babu that night. But they were confused why we have seen that Tinkori Babu had so much of respect for Rajan Babu. But why has he done this? What was the motive? They say that yes, definitely the motive behind this we would never come to know, since the fellow has already, Tinkori Babu has already left for Kolkata now. Rajan Babu was absolutely shaken when we told him about this the next morning. When this thing, whatever they have experienced or investigated, when this all news they gave to Rajan Babu was almost in shock. Rajan Babu was absolutely shaken when he told him about this the next morning. As we were talking, Rajan Babu received a letter. He opened it with trembling hands and read it aloud. Now what happened after this, when they have all thought of that, why Rajan Babu has got all these trouble by Tinkori Babu? finally, when this information was gone to Rajan Babu, he was in shock. He couldn't believe that Tinkuri can do this with me. And you know, while they were talking, while they were having those conversation, Rajan Babu received another letter. And he opened it with trembling hands. What do you mean by trembling? By shaking hands, means shaking with fear. He was so much afraid with another letter that he was almost shivering, you can say. And read it aloud. Loudly he read that letter. Now dear children, what you are going to see in this? This letter will reveal why exactly Rajan Babu has faced all these things. Dear Raju, the letter says, if you are wondering who am I and why I did this, then here is the story. Now here is the story, why, if you are thinking that why have I done this, then listen this carefully or read this carefully. I am the boy whom you had tripped in that 100-yard race on our sports day 50 years ago. Just imagine, here he talks about the story of 50 years ago. Something took place 50 years ago, and about that he is talking about in the letter. He says, I am the boy whom you have tripped. What is the meaning of tripped? By putting your foot when somebody is walking, when we put our leg to make that person fall, that is here the meaning of tripped. Okay, and what he did in that race, since maybe this Rajan Babu wanted to get the medal, and that is why he did it. And by this incident, he says, it was not only that I missed the medal, but I was also seriously injured. He was injured, severe injury this boy has got, and he was seriously injured. But what happened? Unfortunately, my father got transferred to a different town soon after the incident, and I never got a chance to have a showdown with you. See the meaning of showdown? It says argument between angry persons about a disagreement. Here it says that soon after that incident took place, soon after that my father got transferred, and from that place we went to some other place, and because of which I never got a chance to talk to you or to fight with you or to show my anger on you, and because of which that anger was there in my heart there. So you never realize how deeply you had hurt me, both physically and mentally. Here it says, it was not that I was only physically injured, but I too was injured mentally. I was so much injured that remained in my heart for quite long. I didn't know about you till I came to stay in your house and saw your childhood photograph. And he says here, I was not knowing where I am going to stay is the same person. But when I came to your house and I saw your photograph, your childhood photograph, that time I came to know you are the same fellow. And because of which, then and there, I thought of doing something that would cause you a great deal of anxiety and trouble, you for a short time. He says, and that time only I have decided that I am going to do something with you which can cause you anxiety, definitely, which can worry you, which can give you a trouble, but not for long time, but for short time. And here it says, I meant to do no harm. The sense behind it, or what I felt behind it was not that I wanted to harm you severely, but just to make you realize, or just to punish you. This was my way to punish you for the things or the deeds you have done in the past with me. That time, whatever you have done with me, I couldn't express that because we both were not in contact then. But now when I saw you, I have done it, all these things with you. Now that's over. Now that aggression is gone. Now that thing is gone. Let's forget about all these things and move on with our lives. He says, now you enjoy your life. Now no more letters you will be getting. No more tension you will be getting. But now you can enjoy your life, and I too will enjoy mine. And then after that he bids goodbye and wishes and all that to him. And by this, what you have understood, that Tinkuri Babu, how cleverly he did everything, that quite late when he was not there in that town, then only these detectives got to know that he was the culprit. So I hope this chapter you have understood. keep on revising this lesson so that you may understand each and every difficult word of this lesson. Thank you and have a nice day.